Talking about sex seems easy these days. Those beautiful stories and images on TV and in magazines about the most exciting sex, you know what I mean. It's like everyone's having a great time in a bedroom. Well, nothing is further from the truth. Many people have sexual problems or challenges that they don't talk about. Hi, I'm Nienke Dekkinga, a Dutch sex educator specialized in cancer-related sexual challenges. And in this video, I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide on how to start a conversation about sex with your doctor. There is still a world to win when it comes to the taboo surrounding sexual problems. And when it comes to cancer and having certain treatments for it, you should know you're more likely to have sexual problems than others. And detox certainly doesn't come easy to anyone. Most healthcare professionals struggle with bringing the topic up too. If you ask me, it is the responsibility of your practitioners to discuss sex first. But in reality, that probably won't happen. However, it is important to talk to your doctor or nurse about sexuality during or after cancer treatment. They are the people that give you tips, advice, or give you a referral to a sex therapist. So don't wait for them to start a conversation about sex. It can be nerve-wracking, but do it anyway. And if you find it difficult to bring it up, tell your doctor or nurse about it. There's a good chance that they feel precisely the same. To make you feel at ease, you should know you're not the only one who struggles with the topic. In a Dutch survey from 2017, 67% of people indicate that intimacy and sexuality have become worse. But how do you start the conversation? Often those conversations are awkward. The following steps can help you guide the conversation more comfortably and smoothly. You need to know what you want to ask. Things can slip through your mind during the conversation. Noting down beforehand all your questions or symptoms and anything you may want to add or ask your doctor will help you not forget anything. This way, you leave the door well informed. Make sure you're not delaying the conversation till the end of your consultation. This topic deserves time and attention. And above all, chances are you only have a limited amount of time with your doctor or nurse. So jump right in. And to keep things on the tip of your tongue, keep your list with questions and symptoms close to you. Also know that it's okay to feel awkward and a little hesitant at first. But treat it as any other problem or questions you might have. Don't hold back and offer all information that can help them solve your problem or answer your questions. Another important thing is, and this may sound odd, but bring up the topic of sexuality as early as possible, preferably when discussing your treatment plan. A good question to ask is, will this affect my sexual life? Or will I remain as sexually healthy as I was before? Things affect every woman differently, and you need to be on point to make sure you're not going around the topic. Have a clear view on what you want out of the conversation. Tell them the prominent things such as, I don't feel arousal, or penetration is too painful to handle. Things as specific as this will help your doctor to come up with a solution. And this may be a referral to a sex therapist, or just some more information. It can be in the form of reassurance. And it can even change your treatments and give you different options to keep your sex life active, healthy, and enjoyable again. It's okay to be confused about any term the doctor uses. If you don't understand what they say, ask questions. And if you're still wondering about something they said, ask some more questions. Do not hesitate to ask the doctor for help. This is about you and your sexual health. And it's your doctor's job to help you get through this and feel more informed and empowered about your sexual well-being. So go for it. Make sure things around you support you and make you feel like you're in a safe place. Going with someone such as a partner or a close friend will be helpful. And even at any point you feel overwhelmed, you feel safe and have someone listening to the doctor with you. You can also ask for permission to record the conversation and listen to it multiple times to keep things clear and easy afterwards. But what do you do if your doctor doesn't know what to do with your questions or problems you have? Well, it's okay for that to happen. In such cases, you can go to a sex therapist, medical social worker, or even a psychologist or sexologist. They may help you fill in the gaps your doctor can't. If you like this video, click on the like button and subscribe to my channel when you want to see more videos. And if you have any question about this topic or a related topic, drop a comment below and I'll be happy to answer.